Ocean Springs, Mississippi. We're at north 30 degrees, 21.667. West 088 degrees, 45.852. John Wathan, Hurricane Creek Keeper. We're looking at Blood Beach, Ocean Springs, Mississippi.
My name is Lori Williams. I'm from Ocean Springs, Mississippi, and I am a crab fisherman woman.
Hi, I'm Bud Waltman. I'm from Ocean Springs, Mississippi, and I'm a commercial fisherman. I've been a commercial fisherman all my life.
Bubba, tell me a little bit about those scales I'm looking at. What is that?
Myself, I think the white trout or speck trout or pogie scales. Just showed up 2 days ago, and all in, they probably been down here, they probably about 1,000 yards of them.
Tell me what's going on right here, these patches.
But I believe this is where your big blobs of oil, you know, from the waves washed it up on the grass and killed this spot here and all. This spot used to be just as thick as that in that, all the way down where the mud that we showed earlier was down, all the way down that way was grass, and it was like this, and it's patchy like this all the way down the beach and all. And this, to me, I think this is as far as the cleanup crew got when they was cleaning the oil. Right here, from here on out, it's everything's dying.
This is where in the beginning there was marsh grass. The marsh grass has died, and now the soil itself is actually eroding away. It was a thick marsh grass all the way down, and you'll see as we go down the beach where it's actually been ripped up, and the dead marsh grass is laying up in the...
When did this start happening?
Bubba and I started walking the beach in this part of the beach in July, and there was marsh there. There was marsh grass there. So basically since July, we've just watched it deteriorate.
This is where the marsh grass was. And I think this is where we got a big patch of oil, and it's chemically burned. And all, you step on it and it's crunchy. And see, this grass used to be all the way out to where you see the mud out that way, used to be marsh grass. And all in it, it's like this all the way down the beach in spots. The oil come in and it looked like sheets. It wasn't just a solid wall of oil, it was just like sheets come up, landed on the, come up here in the grass, and wherever it hit, it killed.
When it came in the big wads of the slimy, thick brown stuff, the tides were really high and rough.
Yeah,
it was. So it was crashing up into here, which would have been what the marsh was here.
Well, this grass
was crashing up into here, and they never cleaned it up.
Yeah, well, your grass was probably about this high here. Probably four and a half, 5 foot tall. It's just as high as that grass there. So, you know, that caught the brunt of the oil. And I believe that's why this grass hadn't died up here, is because this grass caught it.
In the beginning, when we first started walking down here, there was a path. It was just a path that you walked down, and you were surrounded on both sides with marsh grass.
Well, you got right here where it didn't kill the grass, you'll see the path that everybody's walked over years and years.
This path is what, from where we recorded back there to where our profile picture was done, from that point there, this way, this is what we used to walk, this little path that now in some spots has actually turned to wide open spaces. And up here, it's actually washed away so much out front that it's actually washing into the little bayous, which it won't be long before the little bayou, which is protection for all of the young marine life, is going to be exposed to the direct Mississippi Sound.
So how long has it been since this started washing out?
Probably about,
Since August.
Yeah.
What do you think caused it?
The oil.
Have you ever seen a washout like this before after a hurricane?
No.
Never.
All of this was underwater. And Katrina laid the grass down, but it did come back up.
What does this do for your crabbing out front?
It hurts me. It hurts me bad because this is the nurseries for your baby crabs and your shrimp and your fish.
So if we're getting crab this year, that's not necessarily a sign that everything's okay.
No, the crabs that we're catching this year come from what we call a fall crop from last year, okay, that we're catching this year, okay.
And I think the only reason they're probably catching any crabs at all right now is because the season was shut down for so long. So you've got the crabs that come out of the bay.
Yeah.
Because they go up there and they have their babies and stuff, and then they come out of the bay. And when they fall out of the bay, they go down here, and they also come from out of the Gulf. The ones from out of the Gulf, I very seriously doubt they made it here. I think the crabs that they're catching right now are the ones that came out of the bay.
It's the fall crop. That's what happened. The fall crop is what they're catching right now.
Look, he's right there.
Okay, yeah.
We haven't seen dolphins out here since
April. Or was it? No.
We seen them about a month after the storm. I mean, after the oil spill.
Okay, flounder. I got him a flounder.
There he goes. He's coming close now. We're hearing people, some in Louisiana, saying that they've had it worse than anybody. We've heard some in Florida saying they've had it worse than anybody. Some in Orange Beach, Alabama are saying they've had it worse than anybody. What do you say to statements like that, living in Mississippi on the same Gulf of Mexico?
I think we've all been devastated. You know, we shouldn't separate. You know, we shouldn't fight along, you know, we shouldn't fight against each other. We should stand up strong against all this stuff, you know. And if you don't, we're just gonna separate. We ain't gonna be nothing, you know.